T lymphocytes cannot directly recognize or be activated by antigens on microbes or those that are extracellular in circulation. They are rather programmed to be able to recognize antigens that are presented to it by antigen-presenting cells like B lymphocytes, macrophages, dendritic cells, or other nucleated cells. Very specifically, T cells require peptides that are derived from these antigens to be presented along with certain cell surface molecules called major histocompatibility complex molecules. T lymphocyte possesses a T cell receptor made of an alpha-beta polypeptide chain, which recognizes peptides displayed by the MHC molecule. Now, apart from the T cell receptor, T cells also possess other proteins and coreceptors that are necessary for signal transduction for T cell activation. CD4 and CD8 molecules are coreceptors present on CD4 and CD8 T cells respectively, and these coreceptors bind to the MHC molecule during antigen recognition and are necessary for T cell activation. CD3 complex are a bunch of polypeptides that help in transduction of signals for T cell activation. And CD28 is a coreceptor that binds to B7 molecule present on the nucleated or an antigen presenting cell. MHC molecules are proteins encoded by MHC genes located in the short arm of chromosome 6. There are three types of MHC molecules, MHC 1, 2, and 3, out of which 1 and 2 are important for antigen recognition by T cells. In fact, their function is to display peptides on cell surface of an antigen-presenting cell or a nucleated cell for the purpose of recognition by T cells. Now, an endogenous antigen like a virus or a tumor antigen is broken down into peptides by proteasomes inside the cell and are transported to the endoplasmic reticulum. Here, the MHC1 molecule captures the peptide and is then transported to the plasma membrane where it displays the peptide on the cell surface ready for recognition. Peptide-bound MHC1 molecule is recognized by a CD8 T cell, the T cell receptor interacting with the peptide, and the CD8 coreceptor binding with the MHC1 molecule. CD8 T cells are MHC class 1 restricted and can recognize peptides only bound with MHC1 molecule. An exogenous antigen, captured by an antigen-presenting cell like a dendritic cell or a macrophage, undergoes proteolytic degradation in lysosomes, and the broken-down peptides bind to class 2 MHC in the lysosome. The peptide-bound MHC2 is transported to the cell surface and is subsequently recognized by a CD4 T-cell, the T-cell receptor interacting with the peptide, and the CD4 coreceptor binding with the MHC2 molecule. CD4 T-cells are MHC class 2 restricted, and can recognize peptides only bound with MHC2 molecule.